Hi, Peter here from URender. In this tutorial, I will show you how to set up this nice little shot. The mountains could need much more tweaking time, but I focused more on the clouds and volumetric effects. The fastest way would be to use the landscape object or a displacement map, but in this case I used a mixture between displacer object to get the main shapes and a couple of textures for additional displacement, normal, roughness and so on. So let's start with a brand new render setting and activate displacement. Now I will show you how to get the atmospheric moody result within a few steps. First thing we need is a light source. In the current release, the best choice is a spotlight, because it has the best performance and can also cast extinction shadows, which are very important to get the volumetrics casting shadows onto itself and on the ground. You should position your light somewhere in front of the camera and not in your back. Create a URender light tag and set a slightly saturated warm color. I know that an inverse square falloff may not be the first choice for a sunlight, but in this case it gives additional depth to the scene. The spotlight is approximately 2000 units away from the scene, so we will set the radius also to 2000. Adjust the outer angle and set a soft shadow with small sample radius and low bias values. Create a camera, set the focal length to super wide and add a URender camera tag. Open the render settings and enable volumetrics. You can leave the default values by now. Now create a volume object. First I will create the clouds, so I set it to cube. As a second step, I increase the X and Z size and place the cube above my landscape. When tweaking the values, you will notice some kind of flickering around the volumetrics that stops after a few seconds and blurs out artifacts. That's a cool thing for a final quality rendering, but during tweaking it can be a little bit annoying. To get rid of it, you only need to set the temporal jitter radius slider in the render settings to 0. I slightly increase the octaves to get more overall details and set the scale to 200%. A good way to set how many clouds are visible or not is to adjust the low clip value. To see more details, I increase the volumetrics resolution. Maybe you notice that the resolution in Z is still not enough. When working with volumetrics, you should always set your far clipping plane of the camera as close as possible, instead of increasing the resolution even more. I don't want to have holes in my cloudy layer, so I decrease the contrast a little bit. Time to get some motion for the volumetrics. For tweaking, I decrease the subdivisions to get more performance. The animation speed animates the noise itself, and that's good for simulating the shape deformation of the clouds. The movement values move the noise inside the volumetric cube object. The speed acts as multiplier. Let's check our animation with more subdivisions and see if we are happy with the details of our clouds. Next, activate volumetric shadows, and this casts beautiful shadows from the clouds onto the ground. The intensity of the shadow depends on the density of the clouds. If set to a low density, the shadows become less visible. If 100% is not enough, you can increase the global density scale. Don't be afraid of setting the density to high values. We will add more light into the scene in the next step. I create a second volume object that will act as haze. So I leave it to layer and reduce the density. I switch the subdivisions very often depending if I tweak motion or appearance. A slight noise for the fog, and our basic setup for the volumetrics is done. Now it's time to add some further steps. I don't want these dark areas to turn completely black, so I will add an environment map. It's just a wood environment with blue sky, and it fits good if blurred to 100%. Diffuse image-based lighting adds ambient light based on the environment map. I also activate ambient occlusion. Enable basic fog with a bluish color. By increasing the background strength, we get nice interaction between the fog and the volumetrics. Then I increase the density a little bit until we get a good balance. Note that this is a very simple fog effect and does not interact with light sources like the volumetrics. Activate tone mapping and we are ready to improve the quality of our volumetrics. Just increase the subdivisions of the volumetric shadows and the resolution in the render settings. How high you can turn this on is depending on your graphics card. Have fun with Cloudy Volumetrics and thanks for watching.